I never had a confidence in my art. It puts me in a vulnerable position when I present my art. I finally found the courage to give this a shot. And when I did, it's been just like I was shot out of a cannon. When I can get up on a stage and I can pour out my heart and people get up at the end and clap, that's like incredible. I mean, that's what I live for. I'm Tech Sergeant Abraham Partridge of the 403rd Maintenance Squadron at Keesler Air Force Base. I'm an integrated mission systems technician. I work on radios, navigation equipment, and electronic warfare equipment on C-130J models. Outside of the military, I'm a creator. I write music most people would call folk music. I make art that most people would call folk art. Born and raised in Mobile, Alabama. When I was 18, I went to pursue a theological education. I met my wife. We settled down in Northwest Georgia, where I served in a church. Stayed there about 5 years, and then I accepted a pastorate in the mountains of Kentucky. And then it just became something I couldn't do anymore. I loaded up everything that I owned and my family. I drove back to Mobile and moved in with my mother and started over. Took a job making minimum wage because nobody wanted to hire a Baptist preacher. So then I joined the Air Force Reserve. I was never good at keeping a job prior to being in the Air Force. I would have a job for 2 or 3 months, I would hate it, and I'd move to another one. Whenever I got to Keesler, I was here full-time for 2 years. I finally had a job history good enough to get a halfway decent job, and so I went and worked for the scale company, and then I was coming as a reservist. I deployed with the 403rd. When I came back, I got offered this art job. As an Air Force Reserve technician, it's given me this ability to chase this dream. I'm able to book shows and travel and do a lot of stuff on the weekends that in my previous job I would have never been able to do. There was a songwriter competition held in Gulf Shores, Alabama, and I went there. The first time I played my songs in front of a listening audience, the room was packed. There was probably 200 people in there, and I got just roaring applause and standing ovation, and it blew my mind. I went to Nashville and recorded my very first record 2 months after playing my first gig. I had been touring pretty good, getting out on the road, playing shows almost every weekend while being an art, a reservist, and trying to be a father and a husband. The manager for the label came by my house. I had one piece of my artwork that my wife would allow me to hang in our walls. And my manager said, "Wow, who did this piece?" And I said, "You know, I did that." And they were like, "We love it." It was like the first time anybody had ever shown any interest in that part of what I do. Mm-hmm. And so I made my art public, and within a month, it was already international news. My record, Cotton Field and Blood for Days, just debuted at number 19 in the European Americana charts. I've won a handful of songwriter competitions. I've played at some exclusive songwriter festivals. I represented the Gulf Coast Blues Society in the 2017 International Blues Challenge in Memphis, Tennessee. And I'm not bragging because I'm not saying I had anything to do with it. And I feel like I've been extremely blessed, and I've had some extremely good people come along and help me. The Air Force taught me how to persevere, and perseverance is definitely one of the most necessary traits if you're going to have any success in the arts. If you're doing anything original, when you first start doing it, everybody's going to look at you wide-eyed like you're crazy. It took a long while before I could get anybody to come back to a show, but if you persevere and you believe in your work and you perfect your craft, things will start happening. My advice for anybody that has a passion is just go for it with all you got.